Hello and welcome to Piano Shack with me, Woody. Now, whilst the monologue and the minilogue here are undoubtedly very fine synthesizers, I'm not a fan at all of these knobs. In this video, I'm going to tell you why and also how to fix them. I hope. The issue that I have with these knobs is that the marker that shows you where the knob is turned to is just a groove in the plastic. It's not actually very easy to see at a glance, and certainly it wouldn't be easy to see in a dark studio or stage. Yeah, I don't know what KORG were thinking. On the Minilogue XD, they've actually filled in these grooves with a little bit of white colour, making it really easy to see at a glance what position the knob is at. Exactly the same problem here on this lovely Minilogue. I mean, it's really hard to see these knobs, actually. You can feel it better than you can see it. But I want knobs that at a glance I can see what the setting is. Some owners of these instruments are even taking white paint Sharpie pens and filling in these little grooves with some kind of white colour. I've zoomed in a little bit so you can see what we're dealing with here. Filling these in with white paint is not an option for me because I'm kind of clumsy and it would end up getting all over the control panel here and perhaps looking like a Minilogue bass. Secondly, I don't want to do any permanent modifications to this because I haven't, to be honest, I haven't even played either of these yet. I bought them simply to have some interesting synths to demonstrate here on the channel and do a review of. I don't know if either of these is going to be a keeper, and if I start painting them badly, it's not going to exactly enhance the resale value if I decide to get rid of these. So I have an alternative solution that I'm hoping will work out really good. One is here, and the other is here that we'll unbox right now. So these are chroma caps, replacement knobs by DJ Tech Tools. Who remembers when I modded my KORG Electribe that also had really boring and plain knobs that were hard to see with some of these? If so, then congratulations and thanks. You are a true long-term fan of the channel because that was about 7 or 8 years ago, I believe. These chroma caps are really nice. I'll show you them in just a second, but they are pretty expensive. I think these are about $2 for each knob, certainly here in the EU where we need to import them and pay all the customs duties and so on. So these are about $2 each. These are the caps that I used for my Electribe back in the day. I restored it back to the original format when I sold it on, which I regret doing. That's one instrument I would have loved to have kept. I really enjoyed that KORG Electribe. There you go. So these little chaps then, I ordered in different colours. And you can see we've even got different sizes. This is for a rotary encoder. This is for a regular potentiometer. You can see how we have a very clear marking on all of these. And I bought different colours so that I could colour code and easily distinguish between the different sections of the Electribe. It has different groups of controls for like the oscillators, the filters, effects and so on. I think we even had nice green ones for the volume or something. And I was super happy with these and they were very easy to fit. I'll tell you in a minute how to make sure that these will be compatible with your device if you're thinking about doing something similar yourself. But yeah, they got a lovely textured rubberized feel with a super prominent marker there. So no doubt at all which position the knob is pointing to. But these are expensive, unfortunately, about $2 a pop. If we look at the control panel for the Minilogue, there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48, 49, 50, 51, 52, 53, 54, 55, 56, 57, 58, 59, 60, 61, 62, 63, 64, 65, 66, 67, 68, 69, 70, 71, 72, 73, 74, 75, 76, 78, 79, 80, 81, 82, 83, 84, 85, 86, 87, 88, 89, 90, 91, 92, 93, 94, 95, 96, 97, 98, 99, 100, 101, 102, 103, 104, 105, 106, 107, 108, 109, 110, 111, 112, 113, 114, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 29 knobs to swap out here. This one maybe not so important because it doesn't have a marker, it's just the rotary encoder. 28 knobs, that's about 50 or 60 bucks. So I found these over on AliExpress. I bought direct from China. These are from the US, but I assume they're probably made in China. Who cares? I bought a box of 100 knobs. 100 knobs in here for 20 bucks. Let's just do the maths. Okay, a bit of a struggle, but I think it's correct to say that one chroma cap is the same price as 10 AliExpress knobs. So let's open this up and see if they're any good. Exciting, it's who could think that a bag of 100 knobs would be so exciting? And these were in assorted colours, 10 knobs in each colour. And to me, let's compare. On the right, and I don't want to mix them up because I can barely tell the difference. On the right is a chroma cap knob for $2. On the left, one that is a tenth of the price. Direct from China. I know some of you don't approve of that, but just wanted to save a few bucks. Actually, you can see that the Chinese ones have an even better and more prominent marker. I'll give you a close-up of that. So this is the chroma cap there. These are the cheapos. But they've got the same rubbery texture. Actually really impressed with these. I'm very happy that I got these ones. Colours are really pretty as well. I love these purples, 10 different colours. I'll see if I can find all the colours. Well, I didn't find them all perhaps. I'm just a little bit colourblind, or perhaps blind in general, but perfectly happy with that. You can see a really nice selection of different colours there. Fantastic. So what are we going to do with these? If we take a look at the Minilogue then, it's divided up into different sections: oscillators, mixer, filter, amplifiers, LFOs, effects over here. So what we could do, I guess, is have rainbow colored themes if you want to, different color for each section. But I think what I might do is what I did on the Electribe, just choose two colors that complement each other and have alternating colors for each section. I think that would be pretty nice. We could, for example, do red and black, like a tribute to the Minilogue bass. I think that would look pretty sweet, actually. But I don't want to replace all of the knobs today because I haven't even done my review video of these yet. So I think I'd like to keep it in the original state before swapping everything over. Also, I'll only do this knob swap if either of these is a keeper. And I don't know yet because I haven't really used them. But I think we should swap out one or two just so that we know that they fit. And I'll tell you what you need to be aware of if you're planning on doing something like this yourselves. So if you look closely at these knobs, you can see you've got a marker there, and the shaft size is pretty standard, 1/4 inch, if I recall. But you'll see there's a flat. See, the inside of the shaft has a flat part of it that catches on a spline there. And the alignment of that flat part and the marker is very important. You need to check the knobs on your hardware. And then make sure you order the right one. You need to specify if it's a 90 degree offset or a 180 degree offset. So this is actually a 180 degree offset. You see that? I'm starting to wonder if they've sent me the right one, because I seem to recall when I pulled a knob off one of these and looked into it, I seem to recall that it was 90 degrees that I needed. So yeah, let's take a look. Beginning to wonder if this video is going to be a complete disaster. The Minilogue I bought brand new. The Monologue is used, although in tip-top condition. So let's pull off the master volume knob, see what we're dealing with. I don't want to mess around with my brand new one. Oh, these were easy to remove, so that's a good sign. Let's check what we have here. You see what I'm talking about? There is a, if I turn it there, a flat spot there that you need to make sure is aligned with the pointer on the knob. I think we're going to be okay, that's lucky. You can see the marker and the flat spot in the middle of the knob are 180 degrees offset. They're on the opposite directions. So yes, we're good to go. And I have to say that these knobs feel really plasticky and cheap compared to the equivalent. Let's take this nice yellow color compared to the equivalent rubberized knob. So let's test this out. We have the flat spot pointing over there, the dial pointing the opposite direction, and it fits pretty nice. Actually, perfectly. Look at that. Yeah, happy with that. Maybe the yellow is a good choice for this. It'll be like a Wasp. Who remembers the old Wasp synthesizers? Black and yellow. Yes, I think that's what we're going to do here. Black and yellow. And it was a pretty easy job to swap them. And it's a tight fit as well. I can lift the entire synth up almost with the knob. Cool. So if you are ordering knobs, make sure you buy the right ones, 90 or 180, and you'll have to pull the knob off your synth to check, you know, which one you need. An interesting thing about the Minilogue that I've just noticed is that the control panel is curved. That's a really nice, elegant design by KORG. They could have just made it straight. That would have been easy, but it's curving. So you've got to be careful with the knobs as well, that they don't sort of catch on this concave surface. But I think we'll be okay. You might be surprised, believe it or not, it's a lot of work for me to make these videos for you. All I ask in return is if you made it this far in the video, then please do subscribe to the channel. And thank you so much if you already have. It's just a click for you. It costs you nothing, but it means a lot to me. Thank you very much. Well, that does it for today then. These things almost look like candies or sweets or something. I want to eat them. They look delicious. What was I going to say? Yes, the next time you see these, we'll do a proper full review and demos of both instruments. If I decide to keep either of these, then we'll do a knob switch, and I'll share that with you as well. Okay, that's all for today. I'll see you next time. Cheerio.